everybody, and welcome to the Google live stream for Insurgent. I am Dave Karger, the chief correspondent at Fandango. Very happy to be here in Los Angeles at YouTube Space LA. Even happier to be joined by the two stars of the Divergent series, Insurgent, Shailene Woodley and Theo James. Hi guys, how are you?
Great.
Good.
Good, yeah.
We have so many fans out there all over the world who are very excited to be asking you questions via this tablet. If you have questions for Shay and Theo, please ask them at the hashtag InsurgentGoogle. I have some already chosen, and I'll be choosing some more as we go on. But before we start, we're going to show everybody the most recent Insurgent trailer, so check it out.
Cool.
You are living proof that the Divergent problem has grown beyond all control.
I wanted something different.
I know you're angry, Triss, but you're letting it consume you.
So now we're all officially fugitives.
Divergence will destroy our society.
Kill them both.
We have to stop her together.
This is the only chance we have to rescue what little civilization we have left.
No pressure.
Dark times call for extreme measures.
She's never gonna stop coming after us.
Divergent series, Insurgent, rated PG-13. Experience it in IMAX 3D March 20th.
All right, hopefully that gets everybody even more excited for the movie, which, by the way, comes out on March 20th. If you're in the United States of America, you can buy your tickets now on Fandango, so please do. Okay, here's one of the questions that I loved. So many people are fascinated by the relationship between Four and Triss. It even has a name, Fortress. The relationship does, yes.
Mm.
It's a creative
thing. Which is very, very fitting. It's Fortress, like a fortress.
Okay,
it took me a while. So here's a question from Alaska Shay. If you could pick a song to describe Fortress and the relationship, what song would it be?
Alone by Heart.
Aww.
Oh, nice.
No, I don't know. The song's just been stuck in my head for like 3 days.
It's a great song.
That's a good song. Gangster's Paradise, cool.
Yeah.
A song that fits any occasion.
Like a Bloodhound Gang exactly. kind of song.
Yeah. One thing we learn in this new movie is Four's real name, Tobias.
Mm.
So Four is a nickname. Do you guys have nicknames for each other?
As characters or in real life?
In real life.
Not really, no. I mean, Shay's a good
Theo's pretty, it's pretty simple already. Yeah. It's pretty.
Sometimes Shay calls me T-Dog.
I was about to say T-Dizzle,
that's
T-Dog.
That's a rap name, is it not?
That was my old rap
T-D
name.
T-D for short, though, if I'm like too exhausted to say T-Dog.
Yeah. Okay. And also, what's Jenny? Is Jenny a nickname for you? That's something that came up a lot in the Twitter questions.
No.
I'm sure the Twitter fans are going to school me on what Jenny is. But that was a question from Hannah Clark, by the way. Here's a question from Janice K. Theo, what is the best quality about Shailene? And then you can answer the same question for Theo.
About myself?
No.
She's very generous.
He's incredibly intelligent. Good listener.
Good quality and a friend. Here's a question I'm sure you've gotten several times, but I'd be curious to know the answer. This is from Joshi Nu from Italy. Which faction would you want to be in if you were in this world?
I would want to be factionless because I wouldn't want to be dominated by by any particular force. Okay. Sovereign.
I like that.
I think you'd be Amity.
Amity. I love farming. Yeah. Yeah, I would be Amity, yeah. I think I would. That's what my nickname is sometimes on sets, Farmer Theo.
Theo.
Yeah, exactly.
It is very cool, by the way.
I wear dungarees constantly.
You what?
Wear dungarees.
Oh,
a lot.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay. It's very cool to see the Amity world that your characters are hiding out in the beginning of the movie. Mm. It's such a difference from, you know, the kind of futuristic urban world that we're used to. Was that cool to be a part of and explore a little bit?
It actually was really nice. We started filming those scenes in the beginning of the film, and spent 3 weeks on a farm in the middle of the South, and it was beautiful. Mm. It was nice to wake up every day and be able to film outside and be in that environment versus being on a stuffy soundstage. So.
Yeah, and it was very different, wasn't it? It was kind of, you know, because obviously the first movie we're filming in kind of cold warehouses in Chicago, and the first 3 weeks was in this kind of very pretty farm.
So. With fireflies and...
I like that.
It was beautiful.
Okay, here's a question from Turkey. What have you guys learned from the characters that you play? Did you pick up any traits from your characters?
Physical traits, absolutely. Just in the training that we did in the first movie. And then it sort of doubled over into this. I feel like I picked up on some
skills.
And you've kept it up? Some of the physical stuff that you started just doing for the movie?
I don't know that I've necessarily kept up the exact physical skills that Triss embodies, but yeah.
What about you?
I'm good at, as a result of disappearing, so that, you know, I'll be standing there and then randomly I'll be gone.
You think that's because of four?
Well, that's something I learned when we talked last year. I said, what was his worst trait on set? And you said, he'll just walk away.
Oh, yeah. You do that?
So you haven't changed in that regard. Yeah, that's good. Here's a question from...
He might get up in the middle of...
Yeah, I might.
Please don't, because then... Poor Shailene would have to be stuck with me for 45 minutes. Here's a question from a Twitter user named Aloha Shay. Okay? So Aloha.
There's so many Shays out there.
I know. Well, and they're all asking questions today. She wants to know, or I think that's a she, do you guys watch each other's movies that you're not...
I've seen every single home video that Theo ever made as a child.
Yeah, and I've seen Shay's home video.
Careful.
Have you seen The Fault in Our Stars?
Yeah, I have.
What'd you think?
I loved it. I think it was great. Yeah, I actually...
He watched it for Ansel, though.
Oh. So I watched it for Ansel, yeah. It's quite funny. When we were filming, I came out of the gym, and these girls were waiting, essentially, for Shay. And they had this Fault in Our Stars book. And I was like, okay, cool. And they, you know, I'm not going to sign it, because obviously, you know, there's no point in me signing it. But, you know, I tell you what, I'll take it. And then I'll get Shay to sign it, and I'll get them to send it to you. And then I walk out, and the paparazzi take a picture of me covered in sweat with a copy of Fault in Our Stars. It's like an almost 30-year-old book about two young 16-year-olds.
Theo James, obsessed with Fault in Our
Stars.
Yeah,
exactly, yeah.
And did that picture go everywhere that you saw?
I don't know about everywhere, but it was used, I think.
Well, I hope you then read the book, because you was given, you know, you had your shot to read it.
Yeah, of course. Have you read it?
I have not read it, but I've seen the movie. You're right.
Read it now.
Right, okay. But I love the movie. Did you see him in Downton Abbey before you guys ever met? Did you know who he was from Downton Abbey?
I did see Downton Abbey. I saw that one clip.
I saw Shay in, when I got to the Divergent set, Miles and Shay were kind of hot off
Spectacular Now.
So that was the first kind of, other than, in fact, I saw the Clooney one. I remember I told you in Santa Barbara randomly. But I saw that kind of as soon as I got to set, because that was like obviously my introduction to Shay, really.
I like that. Here's a question from Bluest Blue Ever. What was a scene that you had to film for Insurgent that really tested your limits as an actor?
Were there any really difficult scenes in Insurgent?
Probably the truth serum was a bit funky, wasn't it?
Oh, that was really funky.
Yeah.
What to kind of get across how it's affecting your body.
Yeah.
That's how to do that without being cheesy, and also how to create something that's not real. And it was up to sort of our own discrimination on what we wanted to do.
And we had to kind of confer a little bit and be like, are you, you know, because we didn't want one person looking like
to be like spastic
doing a shit or something. And the other person was, going to pass out, whatever.
So what did you guys talk about as far as what you arrived at, how it would affect you?
We basically arrived at he had to go first. So I was like, whatever you do, I'll just copy it. I think that's really
whatever you do, I'll do it a bit better.
No, but I think that's what happened. Because we talked about it a lot, and we were like, yeah, maybe we'll try that, maybe we'll try that. And then ultimately, I was like, just do what Janet.
Yeah.
Well, thinking back to the movie, it feels very convincing and real to me.
That's good.
Yeah. But I imagine that would have been difficult, yeah. Here's a question from Saudi Arabia. Speaking of your paparazzi shot with the book in your hand, what's a book that you each...
Speaking of my cultural heritage.
No.
Guy from Saudi Arabia. No,
I thought you were Greek. Okay, wait, what's a book that you each think everyone should read?
Henry and June by Anna Eastman.
Why do you love Henry and June?
I just think it's a beautiful account into a female's perspective of sensuality.
Nice. Yeah.
I couldn't give you one.
I'll take a couple.
I could tell you what I'm reading at the moment, which is Joyce's short stories, Dubliners, which is very good, because I find his, you know, Ulysses and those kind of the stream of consciousness thing a bit hard, whereas these are more concise and they're quite interesting and they're little, almost like little short films. They're kind of interesting.
Okay. Here's a question from Malaysia, from GreyBaby24. Which one of you guys is a better singer?
Theo.
Jay.
Theo.
Have you had occasion to hear each other sing?
No.
I've heard Shay sounds a bit like Norah Jones. You have that quality.
Nah, he's got an amazing voice.
Rapping voice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, you do hip hop really well.
Do people ask you to do it all the time?
What?
Hip hop?
Rap?
Rap. Yeah, constantly. Yeah. I do a lot.
Okay, here's one for you, Shay. This is a question from someone in the Czech Republic who says, Triss is such a true hero for me. Do you have a hero of your own, fictional or real?
Yeah, I mean, I think, I feel like the definition of hero is so, it just depends on the way you define a hero, you know?
Ansel would be your hero?
Ansel, yeah. You, actually, Miles. pretty much any male co-star I've ever worked with. to me, a hero is somebody who, in the wake of fear, doesn't turn away from it, but really stands up to it, you know? And it could be a small feat, or it could be a large feat. It could affect one person or 1,000 people. So I don't just have one hero. I think anybody who really listens to themselves and their own integrity, while also being compassionate.
I like
somebody
that.
I admire.
I don't want to butcher this poor woman's name because it sounds like she has a name that's in honor of you. She calls herself Queen Shalinex, and she's from the U.S. I hope I got that right, Queen, your Highness. What was your impression of each other when you guys first met?
The very first time we met?
Yeah, and where was it? Let's hear that.
It was in a casting office in Los Angeles.
I remember it, obviously you remember it quite well. Shay was pretty, you were very chilled and kind of unpretentious.
I've changed a lot then.
Yeah. Yeah, and kind of fairly relaxed. But you definitely have you were like assessing, you know, who is this person kind of thing.
Was I?
Yeah.
Just testing? Yeah, no. I just remember Theo walked in, I was drinking tea. And he was like, what is that? And I was like, it's throat coat. And he was like, oh, can I try it? And I was like, sure.
And then I started making really bad jokes.
And then I don't remember any bad jokes. But I do remember just like him being the only guy in there who was like a man when he walked in. You know, like you have a very strong presence.
Did you hug him when you first met him? Because that's one thing I love about you is when you meet people, you hug them. Even the crew here.
Did I?
I don't think so.
No.
I can't remember. No.
Because it was more of a professional, like...
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe. I think he probably came at me with, like a hand.
Yeah, probably. Very British and formal.
Yeah. Okay. That was shocking, actually, though, because you left. I think you started speaking... He came in with an American accent, and then when you left, maybe you spoke in British tone, or maybe the producers told me you were British. And I was so confused because his American accent was so convincing.
That's good.
I love that. That's a great question, Queen. Okay, here's a question from Sabrina in Chicago, and she wants to know if you guys could steal anything off the set of these movies, what would it be?
There were some really great ceramics from the Amity set. Some really nice like plateware.
Yeah, that's true.
And napkins and silverware. I remember being like, oh, if I had a kitchen, I would snag those.
Yeah, yeah. I think I agree.
Okay. I don't want to be too specific with this, but there are a lot of really emotional scenes in this movie. I don't want to give anything away, but I found this question interesting from a Twitter user named